Dr. Meyer and her team are standing by for a severely injured 43-year-old man arriving by air ambulance from country Victoria. He's fallen 3 metres from the top of a shipping container.
Lots of pain in the back.
Yes.
Lots and lots of medication to control severe pain.
The patient's pain could be a sign of head and spinal injuries.
So, concerns about whether the lots of screaming and pain is head injury or injury to musculoskeletal spine?
Father of three, Matthew, was clearing a fallen tree on his property with a chainsaw when he fell.
Just a few bumps as we come across.
Even though paramedics have given Matthew multiple doses of powerful painkillers, he's still in excruciating pain.
You're at the Royal Melbourne Hospital, mate.
Do you remember what happened?
No.
Pain gives us a flag that there's something going on, and the way that we approach him is to try to figure out if that, in the next 20 minutes, will be the thing that might kill him.
All right, so this is Matthew. He was on top of a container trimming a tree with a chainsaw when the limb that he was cutting fell. The chainsaw fell free, and he fell landing on his coccyx. Head to toe, the only thing we found and the only complaint he's had is this back pain type area, severe in nature.
Matthew's partner saw the accident from their kitchen window and called the ambulance. She's now on her way to the hospital.
He's had a heart rate about the 80, sinus rhythm throughout.
Dr. Meyer's worried about the level of pain Matthew is in.
Matthew, I am Meyer. I'm one of the emergency doctors. It's nice to meet you.
How are you?
So, you've had a lot of ketamine and morphine.
Yeah.
It's quite a lot. I'm not the police, okay? But yeah. I just need to know, do you normally use things? Because it might change how much medication we need to give you to control your pain. Do you use heroin or ketamine or injectable drugs normally?
No.
No? Okay. Whenever somebody has pain out of proportion to what I expect, one of the things I need to do is, what have I missed? What diagnosis am I missing here? And having a good history about what other drugs the patient's using that might affect what I'm giving him. I think we should roll him, see where he's sore.
1, 2, 3. Any pain here?
We've got pain.
Here?
Matthew,
you got pain?
Huh?
Matt.
3.
Well done.
So the only outstanding issues for us are we have no explanation for why he's got so much pain.
Dr. Meyer needs to find the source of Matthew's searing pain quickly and orders x-rays.
I'm prioritising looking for other things that I know might be life-threatening. That's interesting. It's very asymmetric, isn't it? It would be consistent with a supine hemothorax.
The x-ray is suggesting there could be a dangerous bleed around Matthew's lung.
Whenever there's one side of the chest looking a bit whiter than the other, in a lying flat x-ray in a trauma patient, we always get a bit worried that there's bleeding into that chest cavity. But definitive testing is always a CT scan of the chest to find out definitely whether there's any bleeding into the chest cavity and where it might be coming from.
Alright, crossing the count of 3, 1, 2, 3.
The CT's higher quality image should pinpoint the exact problem area.
Please breathe in and hold your breath.
The scan finally reveals why Matthew is in so much pain.
Ow.
And it's not what Dr. Meyer expected.
There's a fracture there. He's fractured the vertebra in his back. It's basically burst apart. I'm seeing a fracture of the spine. It does put him at risk of other complications. For example, a fracture of your back puts your spinal cord at risk, which of course then puts your ability to use your limbs at risk, and the way that you live your life thereafter is dramatically changed.
So far on that scan, we can see that you have broken one of the vertebrae in your back.
In emergency, Dr. Maya Cubitt is telling father of three, Matthew, that he's broken his back after falling nearly 3 metres from the top of a shipping container.
Oh.
The bad news is it's very painful, as you've already realised. The other bad news is we need to leave you lying flat on your back like this while we try to make sure that there's no other injuries of your spine anywhere else.
It's too early to say whether the spinal cord is at risk from the crushed vertebrae, which could mean he'll never walk again.
We have to be careful about not giving information too early. I'm always really careful just to say what I know rather than what I don't.
Thankfully, Matthew's partner, Owena, who saw him fall with a chainsaw in his hand, has finally arrived.
The drive down to Melbourne, it seemed to take forever. Your mind starts racing about all the things that could be wrong with them, all the things that could have happened or didn't happen.
Hi. Rowena?
Yeah.
Did you see what happened?
Yes.
I remember looking at him for a few seconds through the window with my baby and seeing him suddenly fall. I ran out to that spot and the chainsaw was going really loud, but I could hear him shouting out in pain and found him on the floor.
Oh.
You're a lucky guy. I know you don't feel like it at the moment, but what worries me is what would have happened if that chainsaw had gone the other way.
Yeah.
Very lucky.
Yeah. It is going to be weeks in hospital, plus or minus some surgery. Okay?
Really?
Yeah.
Oh.
Weeks. So there'll be a period of in this hospital, and then there will be a period of rehabilitation, and then there'll be a period at home where we're keeping an eye on you, but you'll still be sore and having trouble moving. You are going to have to deal with the injury that you have, and it is going to be a bit of a long road. My advice to you at the moment is just take it one step at a time.
Yeah.
Okay, so hour by hour if you need to, day by day, all right? Try not to think about the big picture, because it can feel a bit overwhelming.
Yeah. I thought, you know, just brush me up and I'll be right to go home tomorrow. But no.
No.
What a bugger.
Who's with your kids?
Matt's mum.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah, how old are your kids?
11, 9 and 1.
Oh. That's always really hard, managing kids and life.
Yeah.
Because for them, life's just going to carry on and you're going to have to figure out how to juggle that. So I would rally in some friends, okay?
Yeah.
This is the time to ring a friend.
When Dr. Meyer and her team took care of father of three, Matthew, he'd been using a chainsaw when he fell off a container and broke his back.
Oh, Tar, good girl.
It's now 3 months since the accident, and Matthew is back home with his partner, Owena, and their children.
That's mine.
There you go.
It's hard to put it into words. It was the most painful experience I'd ever had. I vaguely remember before Rowena called the ambulance whether it was the right call. I thought if we could wait 15 minutes, maybe a couple of Panadol would be okay, but didn't turn out that way.
Matthew had major spine surgery to repair his vertebrae with two steel rods, and the construction worker hopes to return to work soon.
6 to 12 months was the time frame I've been given before I'd be able to pick my daughter up, I suppose.
Come on.
Yeah, they don't understand the reason why you can't pick them up. I think I'm pretty lucky, really. I mean, I could have ended up paralysed, I could have been hit by a chainsaw.
I did a front flip and then basically landed fair and square down there on my bum. Container one, me zero.